It just isn't working out.
My life isn't over. I've got plans.
Such as?
Hovering with a large plank when Veronica's lover comes to the door expecting a pizza delivery.
What, you and Sarah?
We're going to be sharing the flat and the house. It's called nesting.
Oh, this is really nice.
It's called being a deluded prick is what it's called.
But for the first time in my adult life, I don't want Paul.
I get the feeling he's not getting the message.
You fancy Sarah because she had sex with someone else.
I still love her.
I think you're confusing sex and love. It's an easy mistake to make.
No, but just don't confuse sex and love, OK? It's an easy mistake to make.
Can we please stop talking about this before I'm sick?
No, we both fancy each other. I just thought we might have some fun.
I don't fancy you.
Are you saying you regret splitting up with Sarah?
I think me and Sarah are trying to put that right.
Is this about the nesting idea?
The nesting's the first step, yeah. And I think we both know where that is headed.
I should have said this at the time, Paul. But I don't think the nesting is a good idea. In fact, I think it's a non-starter.
You know what, you're right. Who are we trying to kid? I'll just move back in.
That's not what I meant.
Oh, what have we got to lose, eh? Let's try again. Oh, come on, what do you say? Well, she didn't say no, did she? You think I should go after her?
I don't know if that's a good idea.
Yeah, you're right. You're absolutely right. But she does seem to still want me in her life, doesn't she?
Yes, as a friend.
Yeah, I know that, I know that.
So do you think you could be Sarah's friend?
I'm just going to go and ask her. I'll see you next week.
Sarah! You will never find anyone else like me.
Well, I hope not.
You see, that's what we've got you and me, the banter.
You banter with everyone, Paul. That's the reason you got into this mess in the first place.
Oh, come on. We were great together once. We can be great together again.
No! We were great together once, but not anymore. How can I put this? I don't want you to move back in. I don't want to nest of you, and I don't want you back. It's over. I want you to get on with your life and let me get on with mine.
So what are you saying exactly?
I am saying it's over. We're finished. We're done.
All right. Take a hint.
I can't see how we've come so far together, and he's just getting it so wrong. It's like I've been having two completely different conversations over the last 6 months.
Well, that's the miracle we call counselling.
I am serious. I'm single now and he's just got to learn to live with that.
Oh, no, I've seen this stage before. One minute you're dancing on the table singing I Will Survive, the next you're thrown up in the toilet saying I love them back.
Yeah, I'm not that sad yet.
Oh, Julie can take you even sadder.
Why, what have you done?
I've registered with a computer dating agency.
Have you had any replies?
204 so far.
Yeah, but what about after you deduct the perverts?
Five, and one of those was wearing a snorkel in the picture.
Well, isn't it a bit sad and lonely?
Oh, no, no, not at all. That's why it's called Lonely Hearts. It's irony.
It's great. It's no hassle. You just pay a fee and put your details on the webpage.
And 6 months later, the police impound your computer.
I don't think it's that mad an idea. Mm. I'll get these. You sit down.
You know, you should leave her alone, Mark. She can't do worse than Paul.
Hang on, you hardly know me.
Yeah, I know, and he still managed to make a pass at me.
Now, are you sure it was a pass? I mean, Paul can send out very mixed messages. He once got engaged to a woman who stopped to ask for directions.
He asked me to go back to his place.
Well, maybe he just wanted a hand with the decorator.
Why won't you believe me?
Because I don't want to believe you, because I don't want to know this stuff. Why do people have this irrational urge to confess to me?
I just needed to tell somebody.
Okay. Well, you didn't do anything, did you?
No, of course not. Nothing happened.
There you go. Look, I've been thinking. Maybe we should share your dates.
What?
Well, you know, we could divide them up, go together.
Oh, this is just hysteria, ladies.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure it works like that. I don't think it's like a, you know, team effort.
Oh, come on. I need something different. Something that doesn't involve listening to Paul ranting. It's either this or bungee jumping.
Yeah, OK. Yeah, you're probably right. Probably will be more fun with the two of us.
Good.
Can you get yourself to school this morning?
Why?
Oh, got things to do around the house. I can't give you a lift.
I can wait.
You'll be late.
I'm always late.
I'm not going in your direction, not today. I'm on a course.
I have to walk.
What's wrong with the bus?
It's full of, you know, people.
Radiohead, Lloyd Cole.
Old classics.
Why don't you get some Morrissey and lighten things up a bit?
I just need people to understand. These guys have been there. They know the black pit that I'm in right now.
Thought you decorated.
Yeah, I know why you're being glib like this.
Because I'm bored off my tits by hearing you wallow in self-pity.
Because you're suffering too.
Well, I was, but now I've got the earplugs, it's not so bad.
Because you're still upset about being dumped by Lorna.
Lorna?
It's Veronica.
No, I'm pretty sure her name was Laura.
Hello.
I'm Mark, by the way, Paul's chaperone. I make sure he doesn't spend his bus money and that his socks are matching, that kind of thing.
I wondered who's doing that for him now. Pleased to meet you.
So?
So? How are you?
Fine. Good. Yeah. What about you? Still sleeping around?
Oh, grow up.
Did that lack dignity?
I don't think so, no.
Look, I won't be able to rest until I know why she came after me like that.
She was doing her shopping.
A bit of a coincidence, wasn't it?
Oh, for God's sake. I've just had you going on about Sarah for 2 days. What the hell's wrong with you?
I don't want Veronica. It's just this unfinished business. Until I sort it out with Veronica, I can't sort it out with Sarah.
That's a great excuse, isn't it, for the mess of your life, son?
I just need to get things straight between us.
I think you just did that.
No, I didn't. There's still things I wanted to ask her. I got abusive. I'll go around and talk to her.
No.
I'll just go around and see her.
Look, you've got to be kidding. You said yourself you're a man out of control.
Yeah, right. Would you go?
Me?
All you've got to do is tell her I'm sorry. I just can't have this hanging over my head.
Do you promise me this will shut you up?
Probably.
Okay.
My name's Steve. I'm in tyre sales.
There's someone out there for everyone. That has to be right, doesn't it?
I'd like to meet someone with a good sense of humour.
And I'm hoping that you'd like to be my someone. A mate of mine told me to say that.
I enjoy long walks in the country and early albums of Roxy Music.
Sarah, what if we like each other's dates?
Well, we could swap.
Right, but what if mine turns out ugly in real life and yours is really gorgeous?
Oh, then you make the ultimate sacrifice for the sake of my love life.
Right.
Well, I'd do the same for you.
Drink?
Yeah.
night.
Hi, what can I get you?
Oh, I don't know.
Which part of the question was a surprise exactly?
Oh, a white wine, please.
So, your date not here yet?
Sorry?
I couldn't help noticing that your friend seems to have a date. You're too good looking to be the ugly friend, so I should be waiting for someone. That's 350, please. Thanks.
Thank you.
Cheers. I think you'd do better.
What?
Sarah?
Yeah.
I'm Mark. We met this afternoon at the shopping centre.
Yeah. And?
It was a bit embarrassing. Paul just wanted to say he was sorry.
What?
Well, you know, earlier, when he kind of...
accused me of sleeping around.
Yeah. Anyway, no harm done, eh?
Is that it?
Well, and you wouldn't mind just avoiding anywhere you're likely to bump into each other, would you?
So I'm not allowed to do my shopping now?
He's so needy and whiny, he's driving me mad with it.
Wow. Now you know how I felt, don't you?
Oh, well, I'll send them your best wishes then. Shall I?
Well, Rachel's at college doing A-levels, and I'd really like her to go to university because I think I missed out on that. And John's doing that teenage boy thing. Sorry, is there a problem?
I just can't get over... Well, to be honest, I really thought you'd be a bit of a dog.
Oh, well, you saw my photo on the file.
I know, but, you know, nobody uses a recent photo, do they?
Don't they?
Have you taken a close look at mine? I've got a jawline and everything.
I think you're better looking than your photo.
All right. Well, I don't know what to say.
How about saying I look better than my photo too? I'm just going to go to the bathroom. Sorry, I'm just going to have to get that. My sister's in hospital, having twins. Hello, have you had them yet? One out, one to go, apparently. So, how was yours?
Smell of air freshener. I don't know what that can mean, but I don't think it's good.
Mine was crap too. Should we try again tomorrow night?
Oh, I don't know. I thought love was supposed to be a bit more spontaneous than this.
Come on, you can't give up after one night. I knew it was your idea in the first place.
I always hated catalogue shopping. I don't know why I thought it would work for men.
But how else are we going to meet anybody? I mean, we're too old for discos and too young for whist drives.
I think maybe we're missing some of the rules of romance here. I mean, they say that the right person always comes along when you're not looking.
Right, right. And has that ever happened to you?
Never. So try again tomorrow night.
All right.
If nothing happened, then why didn't Mark come straight over here and tell me, huh? Why doesn't he answer my calls? Huh? No, why is his mobile turned off? Tell me that.
It doesn't matter, does it? You and Veronica have split up.
It doesn't give Mark carte blanche to go rooting through my leftovers.
Oh, with poetry like that, it's a wonder that Veronica ever dumped you.
We split up. It was mutual.
Yeah. I always say that.
You just don't move in on a friend's ex like that. You don't. Not if you're a mate.
Why not? At least you know what you're getting.
He's probably moved in on Sarah by now.
Probably.
Can you just stop joking about this for 5 minutes?
I was only trying to cheer you up.
Well, then sit on the whoopee cushion or wear the nail through the head. Just don't talk.
What are you doing?
I thought you'd gone to school.
Had to come back. Didn't like my shirt.
Nice to know you got your priorities right.
What are you doing?
What do you mean?
My computer.
I wasn't doing anything. It was a work thing. But I can't tell you anything because of patient confidentiality and all that.
Right.
Anyway, finish now.
Right.
Did you come see Veronica?
Yeah, I said I was going to.
And?
Oh, nothing much to tell, really.
So why didn't you ring and tell me that? Why'd you leave me wondering what you two were up to?
What, do you think I shagged her? Do you really think that I would sacrifice our friendship for some sordid sexual encounter?
Well, yeah, I think you might, actually.
Ah, lovely. Yeah, thanks a lot.
Right, well... She seemed to care about me at all?
Yeah, she's in a terrible state.
I think breaking up with you has hit her really hard.
Really? Now, was that so difficult to tell me?
So it helps know that she's suffering too, does it?
It's not about that.
No, it's about you, isn't it? You've got me running around to Veronica. Julie told me even had a pop at her. And what for? The truth is, you've got all this shit going on with Sarah, and that's the problem, that you would rather whine about everything else and actually sort it out.
I'm asking for a bit of sympathy here. Don't you think you could at least have a go at that?
When I was dumped by Laura, you came out with much worse shit than this.
You only went out with her for 3 days.
You're still a twat about it.
So what is this? Payback time for some grudge you've been saving up?
I'm just saying that maybe you've reached a time in your life when you can stop being such a self-pitying prick.
Can you try reminding me of my good points now and again?
Yeah, your greatest self-delusion.
One son.
Hi, John.
Have a nice time.
Yeah, we will. Got Monopoly.
Oh, right, he's got geography homework to finish off.
Okay. So where are you going then?
Nowhere special.
Very dressed up for nowhere special.
Just for a drink with Julie.
Right, I see.
Girls' night out.
You don't have to protect me, you know?
I know.
You can be straight with me. I'm a big boy, I can take it.
I'm just going for a drink.
Okay. I'm just saying, don't feel you have to pretend.
I'm not pretending.
Great. Well, seeing as it is just a drink, nowhere special, have a nice time.
So, why didn't you just come out with it? Tell him you're going on a date.
I was just trying to be nice. Now I feel like I was rubbing his nose in it.
No, rubbing his nose in it would be if you'd turned up wearing a wedding dress.
Well, let's just hope tonight's worth the trouble.
Yeah, of course it will be.
You change chin.
Oh, well, I've been infected by your touching but hopeless optimism.
Your date's better looking than mine, isn't it?
Now then, come on. You know, looks aren't everything.
Shit, I bet he is. Mine did look like he'd have a nice smile.
You know, that is the sort of thing my mum used to say about boys at school I never fancied.
To be honest with you, he was mostly frowning on the tape.
Yeah, well, you've got to be the woman who teaches him how to put a smile on his face again.
When did my life become a country and western song?
White wine?
Oh, you remembered. I'm touched.
I remember your drink. But you can flatter yourself if you like.
Thanks.
No, really, I do remember you. And your date, who you didn't like at all.
What makes you think that?
I was watching you. You had the fixed smile of a hostage on a video.
I thought he was quite nice, actually.
No, I don't think you really mean that at all, do you?
You're wasted behind a bar.
I'm not just a barman.
Nobody ever is.
I'm a chef.
Really?
Oh, now finally she's interested in me.
What?
You've never asked a question about me until now.
That's because I can never get a word in edgeways.
That's because you're a snob.
No, I'm just surprised.
You're not interested in barman.
I'm not interested in this barman because every time he opens his mouth, he says something irritating. Oh,
but now I'm a failed restaurateur, you can see me for the natural wit that I am.
I've got nothing against barman.
Hello, I'm Gordon.
Tonight's victim not turned up yet.
Doesn't look like it.
On the house.
Thanks. Thanks.
I'm looking at the suit and thinking, funeral director, right?
Piss off, solicitor.
The law? Is me bored off your head?
I am, but at least I'm not slicing lemons and pretending it's art.
I was a snob, Gordon.
Sorry?
I mean, how long have you known me now?
About an hour.
And from what you've seen of me, would you say I was a snob?
No.
I know I don't buy my jeans in supermarkets, but I don't think that makes me a snob, does it? Sorry, what did you say?
Sorry, I've forgotten.
Oh, that is gross.
What is? Can I buy Mayfair?
I don't want to live in Mayfair's full of tossers.
You haven't really thought through the principle of this game, have you? She'll go, Rach.
You go for me.
Go for me too.
What is this drivel you're playing me?
D4.
Hardly the Beatles, is it?
Thank God.
It's crap, John. How can you listen to that stuff? It's just crap.
It's only a song, Dad.
Yeah, does your mum know you listen to this stuff?
She doesn't notice.
What do you mean she doesn't notice? How can you not notice that?
She's too busy on my computer.
What's she doing on the computer?
It's men.
It's men? What do you mean, men?
Nothing.
What sort of nothing?
Men she might go out with.
Computer dating? How's that gonna help him?
Now go ballistic. We think it's as disgusting as you do.
It is not disgusting. It's your mum's life. That's what she wants to do.
Why would she want to do that?
So is there a Mrs. Tom at home raising tiny cocktails?
No. I tried marriage twice before I finally realised what was making me miserable.
You're pretty cynical.
Well, you'd be cynical if you saw men and women at last orders as often as I did.
Don't tread on a girl's dreams or anything, will you?
I'm not saying I'm not romantic. Just realistic. So why are you bothering with all this lonely ass stuff? You're clever, you're sexy, you're funny.
Oh, yeah. So what's the punchline?
I'm just glad your date didn't show.
So am I.
Stop the film halfway through.
Well, you seem to have a good time.
I was just making the most, being stood up.
Oh, why not?
He's a laugh, isn't he, that Tom?
Oh, on first name terms now, are we?
Come on, he's pretty cute.
Oh, don't get me wrong, I think he's gorgeous. That's what makes it even more annoying that he's so smug. I hate that.
Well, what is there to hate? He's just a really funny guy.
Oh, yeah, and doesn't he know it? He's one of those men that goes on and on about knowing you. He doesn't really know you at all. So that cheap psychology stuff. I noticed this about you and that about you.
Well, he seemed to like you more than you like him.
Do he?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's a pity.
But nice to know.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's always nice to know. Just wondering if I could use the computer for a minute.
Again? I've got the yardies on my back here and I'm trying to land a major heroin deal.
Mm. Economics homework, is it? So, how long are you going to be?
busy.
Go on, John. We're doing this thing at work about men's health. That's the reason I was on the computer the other day.
Yeah, right. At least Dad knows he's a loser.
So your son found out you were serial dating. It was bound to happen sooner or later.
Well, it's not how I wanted it to happen, because, you know, it can be taken the wrong way.
Well, make it look like his mother's a desperate old slut, you mean? I'm sure that's not how John would have seen it.
Do you think it's that bad?
Well, I've always said this computer dating would cause nothing but trouble.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Ooh, right. So you've found someone you quite like, have you?
Sort of. He's actually the barman that works at the place where we've been meeting our dates.
Oh, really?
I can't quite decide whether he's a complete arsehole or actually quite nice.
Nothing like a woman who knows her own mind.
So when I want to go steaming in there like some adolescent schoolgirl, I want to take it slowly.
So why are you telling me?
I don't really know if I'm getting the message across. And I really want to talk to him, but every time I do, all this abuse just comes out.
God, you sound just like Paul.
Well, what's Paul got to do with this?
Oh, I had a row with them this morning. I'm sick of reassuring everyone about how lovable they are.
You two fell out?
Nothing two pints won't solve.
Yeah, that's usually what it takes, as long as you're paying.
You know, it's about time you two realised you're getting divorced. And if you got on with that, you might be able to start getting out there and enjoying yourselves instead of bending my ear every 10 minutes.
You're not going to shut the door again in my face, are you?
Sorry about that. Just can't pretend to be happy when I'm not.
Well, you managed it and we're married.
So you said you wanted me to be honest. John tells me you've been computer dating. That sounds classy.
It's called getting on with my life.
Well, I am so glad for you that you are finding it so easy to move on.
Mark told me you're still feeling sorry for yourself.
Mark, what does he know?
So you two have had a tiff, then?
He's really pissed me off. He just thinks everyone's there for his own amusement, you know? He's not a mate.
I know you don't mean that.
It seems like the whole world knows what I feel better than I do.
I've got this letter from my solicitor. It's all about how much money and stuff we've got. I thought we should try and go through it ourselves.
Right now?
Well, it's crazy to both of us be paying legal fees when we could try and sort it out in one conversation.
So it's about the money, is it? Well, you know, it's easy to say let's be friends and behave like civilized adults, but in the end it's tough, you know?
Do you think it's been easy for me?
Well, you seem to be coping.
You've got a choice here. It can always be like the other night if you want. We could drop off the kids and not speak, and we could talk through solicitors. Or we can talk to each other. It's friends or nothing. You're a bit old for your 6 months check, aren't you?
I just wanted to see you.
Well, why don't you just come round the house?
I'm hardly ever in these days.
I've been out for a couple of nights this week. It hardly makes me Tara Palmer Tomkinson, does it? Is there something wrong, Rachel?
No, I'm just thinking maybe I could move back in with you. You know, I just want to be home again and stuff.
Because you miss me?
Mum.
Yeah, great. Have you told your dad this is what you're planning?
Yeah.
Really?
No.
Well, I think you ought to tell him before you move out.
I'll see you later.
OK. Rachel, look, please tell your dad. He's had enough nasty surprises this month.
Yeah. All those times when
our lips were kissed, our tongues were tied. Oh? Alison?
Yeah.
Good. Great. You got time?
Yeah. Right there in your...
I don't know if it's important you should know this, but I've never done this computer dating business before.
Me neither.
Oh, good. Not that it would have mattered. Both single people, so.
Yeah.
And you said on your form you like cinema, so I thought, you know,
It's not a classic like The Bodyguard, but hell, give it a go.
Did you think The Bodyguard was that good?
No. No, not at all. I was joking. I thought I'd try a bit of ice-breaking irony.
I don't guess it.
I was pretending that The Bodyguard was a classic for comic effect. Because The Bodyguard is so blatantly not a classic, I thought you'd find it amusing.
New dress.
Well, it was in a sale.
So where have you arranged to meet them then?
Well, I thought we could go back to the same place.
Oh, don't you think we need a change?
Well, I'm superstitious. I think we should stick to the same team.
It's been unlucky so far.
Exactly. So would you a break?
All right, then, if you can't think of anywhere else.
Oh, hi, we were just going out.
Sad.
John, if you've got a problem with me dating, you know, we could talk about it.
I don't want to know. It's too gross.
What did you think?
I can never have an opinion about a film immediately after I've seen it.
But if you could have an opinion, what would it be?
Well, like I said, I can't.
Okay. Sure. Do you want to eat?
Oh.
Chinese?
Yeah.
Great.
But I'm not eating carbohydrates at the moment.
All right. Don't worry, forget it.
No, you're obviously hungry. I'll come, but I won't have anything.
You don't want to watch me eating Chinese on my own if you know what's good for you. How about a drink?
How's your beer?
I've had better.
The barman assures me that it's a good vintage. It isn't usually this noisy.
What?
This bar isn't usually this noisy.
Have you been here before?
No, I'm just guessing. Do you want another one or should we go somewhere else?
Where?
Well. You know what? There was a time when I would have been too cowardly to say this. But I'm going through this new phase in my life where I'm trying to be honest. And I think we've probably seen too much of each other already, don't you?
Thank you. Ladies?
Hi. Hi. Have you seen any strange men hanging around?
Go in this place, take your pick.
So my date hasn't arrived then?
I think Sarah's is over there. And I sent yours home.
You didn't?
I did. Well, it wasn't right for you, I could tell.
What did you tell him?
Well, it took a lot of persuading in the end, so I just told him that you'd been in every night and I thought you were a hooker.
You didn't?
I'm afraid I did.
Maybe we should just call it a night.
Oh, no, I'll be all right talking to Tom. You should go and introduce yourself.
No, I mean, it's not fair on you.
Oh, go on. He looks nice.
Okay, but I don't think I'll stay long.
Stay as long as you like. Don't worry about me.
You're up early.
I couldn't sleep. I just kept thinking what a crap time I had last night. Julie ruined everything.
How?
She got off with the barman.
Your barman?
My barman, exactly.
And did Julie know you fancied him?
Well, of course she did.
How did you tell her?
Well, not exactly, but she knew.
Did you tell the barman you fancied him?
No. I thought the rule was not to come on too strong.
See, that was your rule. And maybe Julie's a bit more direct than you are. When you were there with a date of your own, if only your man had done the decent thing and stood you up.
He was just so nervous. He talked and talked. The only thing that stopped him was when he had to use his inhaler.
Who were you dating? Tiny Tim?
Julie didn't even want to go to the bar last night.
OK, so she got very lucky. Now, you can't blame her for getting lucky, can you?
You say so.
Now, you better clear off. I'm going to make it up with Paul.
Oh, well, good luck. You'll need it.
Oh, I'll be fine. I've got biscuits.
Get the kettle on. Why not splash out for once and change the tea bag?
What do you want?
I can't move on. I've got the mother of all biscuits here.
You can't come in here and just pretend nothing's happened.
What?
You call me a self-pitying prick, and you think you can come in here and win me over with a packet of hobnobs?
Chocolate hobnobs?
For the first time in my life, I'm on my own. I'm lonely. I need help. But all you can do is play the smug twat again.
You're serious, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
But we argue all the time.
Yeah, I know, but I never realised you were thinking I was a tosser all along.
I wasn't. Oh, come on, if you can't take the piss out of your mate, then who can you take the piss out of?
Taking the piss is all you ever do.
Well, only because you make it so easy for me.
You see, you're kind of proving my point.
Oh, yeah, oh, by the way, I lied about Veronica. She wasn't sorry you'd split up. She was glad.
Bar like that.
That's all right.
So did you have a good night in the end?
No, not really. No point in asking if you did.
Went to this excellent club.
Very cutting edge.
Something else wrong, Ernie? You seem pissed off with me.
I just didn't think you were interested in, that's all.
Didn't you?
And, you know, the way you talked about him, anyone would think you were trying to push him my way.
You gave me the impression you hated him.
When?
Let me think. When you said, I hate him. That was a big clue.
I told you I thought he was gorgeous, and you said he liked me, and I said that was really nice.
And?
And that's pretty clear that I fancied him.
No, it wasn't. It was like, that's nice to know, but I'm not going to do anything about
it. Now you're just trying to twist what I said to make yourself feel better.
I had no idea. I'd never have done it if I thought you'd be upset.
But you knew he chattered me up. It's not that much of a mate.
I don't remember you bagsying him.
What?
Oh, Sarah, how old are you? What, was he yours first because you fancied him but didn't tell anyone? You like David Cassidy, so I have to like Donny Osmond.
If you're a real mate, you've been a bit more sensitive.
I am a real mate, and you've had a bad week. You've had shit dates, your divorce is coming through, you're feeling really sorry for yourself, so you're taking it out on me. Wasn't even my idea. I never thought we should share dates in the first place.
As long as you get what you want, you're fine, aren't you? It's like you started chasing after your ex-husband because he didn't like you anymore.
But I've been protecting your feelings all week.
How?
By not telling you that Paul made a pass at me.
What?
Paul made a pass at me and I didn't tell you because I thought it would upset you, and it's been killing me keeping it a secret, but I did because I didn't want to hurt your feelings.
Well, why would it? I'm divorcing him.
Oh, right, so you're telling me that you wouldn't have been upset?
You're just saying this because you're feeling guilty.
Do you think I'm making it up?
So why are you telling me then?
I'm telling you because you pissed me off and I'm a better mate than you deserve right now.
Bye then.
about Rachel moving back in with you, it was all her idea.
I'm sure.
She made a decision based on a mature assessment of my mental health.
I'm fine with Rachel moving back. It's what I want.
Yeah, me too. It's best for her. So, how's the dating going?
Yeah, really well. The guy I fancy got off with Julie.
Well, these things happen.
Well, you should know.
What?
Well, surely you can see the attraction of Julie, can't you?
Me?
Julie told me you made a move on her. Ah.
Yeah, I did.
You actually admit it? You don't even want me to wheedle it out of you?
Look, I was feeling sorry for myself. I went round to the house. I wanted to see you. Julie and me shared a bottle of wine, and yeah, I made a pass at her. She told me to go home and enjoy my own company, except she wasn't quite that polite. Look, it was lazy, it was stupid. But at least one of us had the sense to see it. I'm sorry.
Don't be. There's no need.
But I am. I've made progress. I still make inappropriate moves on women, but at least I regret it the next day.
Well, you seem to have calmed down a bit.
Well, I went out on a date of my own last night.
Oh.
And she didn't get one of my jokes.
Maybe they just weren't very funny.
It's the kind of stuff I say all the time. I just know you would have laughed.
Don't spoil it.
Don't worry. Didn't make me think I had to go and get you back or anything. Just made me think. I couldn't stand not being able to talk to you, have a laugh with you, protect you from our kids. It'd be such a waste. So I'm gonna, you know, try this being friends thing. Unless you suddenly decide you'd want me back.
I don't think you really want to come back, do you?
No. Don't think I do. Is that a sigh of relief?
You weren't supposed to hear it.
Does this mean I can borrow money off you now?
No.
What does it friends do again?
Fall out.
We should be able to pick that up easy enough.
Waiting long?
Not really.
Your room's ready. I've put up your Barbie lampshade just how you like it.
Ha ha ha.
I'm very touched by your reasons for moving back in.
Right.
But I'm not sure you're telling me the full story, are you?
If you don't want me to move back in then?
Well, now you're being a bit childish.
You're worried I'm going to get in the way of all your boyfriends coming round?
Oh, now we're getting there at last. But you don't have to keep an eye on me, you know. I'm not on the slippery slope.
Well, who are these men you've been downloading?
I know it'll be a bit strange for you and John when I start a new relationship. It'll be strange enough for me, but it's not like I'm gonna get married or make a fool of myself or anything. I'm not some lovesick teenager.
Just try not to do anything too humiliating.
No, I'll leave that to you.
There you go.
Thanks. Present.
Thanks.
Paid run out prawn cocktail.
That's the thought that counts.
I know I didn't handle the whole thing very well. And, well, the thing is, I got it all wrong. And, I was a bit out of line. Sorry.
You did go a bit over the top, but it's okay.
What, so that's it? You made up? It's that easy. What happened to shouting and threatening each other and everything?
Oh, and for the record, I bagged you David Cassidy.
Oh, no chance.
Oh, come on, don't be greedy. You've got Tom.
Well, actually,
what?
I was going to tell you anyway, but I don't think I'm going to be seeing Tom again. He's a bit full of himself, and he can't dance.
Cute, though.
Yeah, I think we've established that.
So you both like a guy, then you both don't like him, and then you're friends again.
You finally understand women.
Oh, well, that's clearly where I'm going wrong with Paul. Do you think all I ever do is take the piss?
So, did you actually go and apologise?
Well, no, that would have been a bit gay, wouldn't it?
Oh,
That is primitive, even by your standards.
No, all I'm saying is that men don't say sorry. Well, not in words. They just ignore each other for a while, and then they bump into each other, and they talk about football, or women, or widescreen TVs that it's forgotten about. That's how it's done. That's the method that's been handed down over the centuries.
Well, you might have to go that extra mile this time.
Apologise?
Well, if it doesn't work out, you can always take my place at Merit Guidance.
Hey, hello.
Hiya. I'm just waiting on Sarah.
Bye.
Julie.
What?
About the other night.
Look, I've already forgotten it.
No, I want to say this. I was out of line. I was really stupid making a pass at you like that, and I'm sorry. But it won't happen again.
Okay. Fine. Apology accepted.
Good. And we'll always know that it would have been great.
Pardon?
At last!
Hiya. See you later.
Yeah, see ya.
I think I smoothed things over with Julie.
Right. I'll apologise to her later. Talking of smoothing things over, Mark's in a bit of a state about you not talking to him.
Good. He's no idea what a twat he's been.
I think he has. You're not going to fall out for good, are you?
I don't know. Sometimes it's hard to see what you liked about someone in the first place.
Yeah. Tell me something I don't know.
Suppose it'd be hard to find a five-a-side goalie quite as funny as he is, though.
So, where is it you're taking me?
It's this new place called Marriage Guidance. Anyone who's anyone has seen them.
Oh, I thought Marriage Guidance was for couples trying to get back together again.
No, in this case.
Amen to that.
Humility. To value what you've got. Honesty. Don't chat up every woman you meet because you might end up with them. Humility.
You already said humility.
Just goes to show how humble I feel.
And now you're boasting how humble you are.
Sarah, what do you think you've learnt from our sessions?
I've got another one, actually.
Well, I think that the next time I have a relationship, we just check that we mean the same thing with words like love and commitment.
I don't think it's just us that can't communicate.
No, I expect you're right. But it would be nice to be with somebody that doesn't run out of the room screaming when you ask him, what are you thinking?
If that's going to be a ground rule, you might want to think about giving up relationships for good.
I think what you have to consider...
So are you saying you never want a relationship again?
Oh, I want a relationship. Everybody does, don't they?
Can I say my other one now?
You always want the last word.
No, it's just that after 20 years, nobody knows me better than Sarah. And nobody knows Sarah better than me. And we have shared so much stuff together. That's probably always going to be the case. So, well, it would be a pity to lose contact with the one person you have shared the most with in the world, wouldn't it? You might want to say yes here.
Yes.
Michelle Collins is one of the few stars